Minister of Hand Jobs Matt Woodworth found to be holding these licenses hostage in exchange for blowjobs. That's right. He was forcing them to perform oral sex and then signing a waiver saying they're proficient in hand jobs. Not only is this incredibly corrupt, but it's also deprived countless upstanding male citizens from proper hand jobs. Kelly?
Keep my name out of your mouth, you fat piece of shit. Ready, set, play.
Both agree. So I propose this. The city allows for licensed masseurs to give genital massages if the masseur and the client both agree to it. We let someone get naked and have every other part of their body touched and rubbed by massage therapist. Hell, we let proctologists spend their day fingering men and sticking things up their anus. So if someone wants to yank a guy's crank, I say let him. Picture this, a big old sweaty
dude in the back
guy. Would getting him off with your hand actually be that much worse than giving him a
lady doesn't
body
seem to care
massage, getting up in there under the folds of fat, or being the proctologist sticking your finger up his ass? And that brings me to my last point. This is about a group of people imposing their morality on the rest of society. If a grown adult wants a hand job, another grown adult, and another grown adult is willing to give one for money, then let them. That's both freedom and capitalism, and that's the foundation of our country. If you have a problem with a genital massage, then don't get one, and allow other consenting adults to do what they want. That would truly be a happy ending for us.
Bravo! Bravo!
I like the way he awkwardly walks behind a pole and hides at the end, but...
I like the way he's wearing shorts to the council meeting.
And a button-down shirt. I like it.
Shorts and a button-down shirt.
So where do we stand on this issue of licensed masseurs giving hand jobs?
Well, I don't even think we should have to make them get licensed. Like, should just be able to give out the hand job. What kind of qualification could you possibly need? Was I qualified at age 13?
13.
I wasn't qualified at age 11, and I kind of got that ball rolling. No, you don't need qualification to be a hand job masseuse, a happy ending masseuse, I guess they would say.
I mean, I'm just thinking out loud, processing this. What if I perhaps worked on the licensing board and held the inspections for these places and decided who was qualified and who wasn't?
Oh, man. See, they would you would get in trouble a couple years down the road. They'd be like, Minister of Hand Jobs Matt Woodworth found to be holding these licenses hostage in exchange for blowjobs. That's right. He was forcing them to perform oral sex and then signing a waiver saying they're proficient in hand jobs. Not only is this incredibly corrupt, but it's also deprived countless upstanding male citizens from proper hand jobs. Kelly?
It's really well done.
Absolutely, John. It's a damn shame. What? Yeah,
that explains the overabundance of toothless handjob practitioners. Woody has a fetish.
Yeah, what is the argument that you shouldn't be able to get jerked off at a masseuse or a massage parlor?
I guess the argument against prostitution in general. They just think that some people shouldn't have that job.
I don't like that. I take the opposite position.
You think everyone should
definitely have that job.
We really need someone to argue. Where's Destiny? I feel like he would be to the left far enough that he would be against hand job practitioners.
No, you got to go around the world twice to be on for that to be a left. Left leaning.
No, you don't, because you get people who are like, women should be able to jack off whoever they see fit. It's their womanly right. And then they go, no. You know, the other side, you can't do that. You don't know you're being exploited. And they're like, I'm making a lot of money to go like this.
Maybe it's the edges of the spectrum in general, right? Because I can see guys at the right, with their Christian objections.
Oh, I would see the right as being way more against it because of the religious bent than the left, where they'd be like, this is the degenerate for our culture. We can't just have women tugging you off after they're sensually touching you. That would seem almost natural. But you don't want to. I've only got one massage ever, so I don't have the experience. But I know that afterward, I was so relaxed and didn't feel sore anymore that I didn't want to go home and have to jack off myself.
that relaxation is why. So I've never done this, I swear I haven't. But it seems like If I were to do it, I'd want a happy beginning, right? Let's kick it off that way, and then just a massage for the next hour.
See, I almost disagree. Like, I was fighting off falling asleep during the massage, and I was like, I'm not going to fall asleep during this. I'm paying for this muscle soreness to go away, and it feels nice. If I fall asleep, I'm going to wake up in, you know, an hour, and be like, all right, now you owe me XYZ. And it's like, oh, fuck, I just took a really expensive nap. Whereas at the, if they jack me up in the beginning, I'm for sure falling asleep. At the end, though, you get a nice, relaxing drive home. You know, you're loosey-goosey.
I can see an argument for both. I really can. I just...
You should get the massage at your house, though. You should get one of those ladies who comes over with a big folding table and sets it up in your living room, and then you don't have as far to go. You can have the auto blow right there.
Oh, that's a good call.
Yeah.
I don't want her using the auto blow on
me. No, I think he's suggesting you get a regular massage, and then... You finish on your own.
Oh, no, no.
Oh,
No. She will be coerced into using the auto blow on.
I don't know what I was thinking. My apologies.
Oh, that'll mesh well with the jungle soundtrack that she's playing to try and relax you, like the trickling of waterfalls, the faint. You know, I don't think they put monkey screeches in those. In those I'm going to play you some. This is called.
Like Pokemon, the monkey sound is like a rare sound within the soundtrack. So at 3 a.m., you just bolt up, Mr. Jingle.
Jingles. Want to be just finishing up your nice, relaxing massage, and she's like, "Oh, you like a happy ending?" And I'm like, "Yeah, sure." And she goes, "All right, one sec, I plug in. You have extension cord?" I'm like, "Yeah, I guess. Give me a sec." And then you come over, lay back down, already a little frazzled, and then you just have to lay there and pretend you don't hear the ning 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 ning. You know, it would ruin it. That would take me all out of it.
That's my fetish. That's exactly what I want. I'm glad you went with the Korean barely speak-a-ty English masseuse. That is not the one I would have went with.
You need to use your auto blow often enough that you have a Pavlonian response to how sexy that is, right?
Go past a construction site. It's just lights out. Just game over. I hear all that machinery.
You can't get like two. Into an auto blow or something like that. That's like those people who get way too into the crazy side of porn, because then like they find a real woman they want to fuck, and they're like trying to inject all their crazy shit in there, and the real woman's like, whoa, I met you 3 days ago or whatever, you know, I'm not ready for this. But you're like, oh, I need you to like really put on this bib and put this binky in your mouth and then spank me what was that thing Medicare said, poopy diaper lovers or furry diaper lovers or whatever. Like, you can't introduce that stuff into your obsessive porn watching, because then you won't be able to get off to just regular Vagu.
Vagu?
Vagu. Wow. That
sounds like,
it's both the like spaghetti an sauce and a and the private part.
Like a delicious appetizer. Like,
it's a white sauce.
Oh, I processed the gruel reference. Got it.
Yeah. Well, this has started off tactful.
Welcome to the show. Painkiller already.